Hello?
Godja, Destinia, the Cajdias.
You what? Nah. Didn't call for room service.
Vinici, Shako Cajdia!
Okay. Wait a second. Right. Let's take this from the top.
Okay, so speaking other languages might be useful when you go on holiday, or maybe if you're in a sticky situation. But what use are they if you're not abroad? Most people in London speak English, don't they? So what use are language skills for a career here?
British Airways flies to over 300 destinations in the world. We carry 34 million passengers a year, and the majority of our workforce are customer facing. So if we don't have people who work for BA that can speak languages, we don't really have a successful business.
Languages are very important to our company because we're a company that is based, our head office is in France, so languages are used all day, every day in our offices in the UK and also in our offices in France and around the world.
I work now for VSI, which is a subtitling company. So basically every day I translate programs for the French television. Everything which is TV series, corporate videos, films. We work in our company, we have a big translation department. There are 7 languages represented. Obviously, we have the English department, we also have a German, Spanish, Italian, French, Chinese, and Japanese department. So, we're quite a big team. For the French department, we do the CSI. So, CSI Miami, Las Vegas, and New York.
So, language skills are obviously important. But I want to know about careers out there for me using languages and how I might use these in the job.
In a lot of medical situations, often at the GPs, but mainly in a hospital, maybe with consultants, maybe actually in an operation, a procedure, and having to hold someone's hand as they're sort of going through the painful and nervy experience.
Firstly, as a medical student, it's been really useful knowing some of the Latin languages, such as French and Spanish and Italian, because a lot of the medical words come from either Latin or Greek. So being able to recognise them and understand them without anyone having to tell you what they mean is definitely an advantage.
But if there's so many companies looking to employ people who speak other languages, how do we know which languages are the most popular or most useful?
Добрый день. Меня зовут Бриджит Кендл, я работаю корреспондент для BBC. Buongiorno, io sono Bridget Kendall da BBC. Guten Tag, ich bin Bridget Kendall von BBC.
Hello, I'm Bridget Kendall from the BBC. I'm diplomatic correspondent. I've been doing this job for 10 years. Before that, I was correspondent in Washington, and before that, correspondent in Moscow.
I don't think I'd be here if it wasn't for my language skills. We operate right across the world, so any language is relevant, but more importantly, it's the understanding of different countries and the ability to communicate well with people for whom English is not a first language.
It's going to be important for you if you want to be involved with it, and that's an excellent opportunity for you to practice your languages.
Spanish is probably the main one right now because it's spoken about 26 countries in the world, so it covers a lot of destinations, but also BA is looking to merge with a Spanish airline, and if that happens, then people at all levels of the business will need to be able to speak Spanish.
So we're very happy to support language skills. All staff, whenever they start, are entitled to have French language training. This may be at a basic level if they've never done French before, but would like to understand it and integrate into the company. So technical skills plus language skills are very beneficial on top of that.
So, whatever level of language knowledge you've got, there's lots of businesses looking for your skills. That sounds great.
I don't think that you'll find on an application form that it says you've got to speak languages, but it can definitely be an advantage. And obviously for some jobs, it very much enhances your chance of getting them. I mean, if you're applying to be Beijing correspondent and you happen to speak Chinese, you're probably front of the queue.
Personally, it's given me a lot of experience that I don't think I could have had otherwise. And career-wise, it's had a massive impact, because I was told that when I joined British Airways, part of the reason they had employed me was because I had German language skills. And when I got this job, I doubled my salary overnight, and it's made a massive difference.
I guess languages can make a difference in other parts of your life, can't they?
Also on a personal level, I get to practice my Spanish, which is really nice because otherwise I would never speak Spanish in London.
I started studying languages at school and I was able to go on a lot of school trips, and I spent 2 exchange trips to Germany, one in Cologne and one in Berlin, and I was able to go to Berlin at the time when the wall was coming down, so that was very interesting.
Raising cultural awareness among employees is very important. For example, it's different, understanding why people, how people react differently towards different situations within the hotel industry. As a good example, Chinese people and Japanese people don't like the number 4. So we tried not to give them rooms on the 4th floor because that can mean death in their language. With Japanese clients as well, they don't like to have fried eggs, bacon, sausage for breakfast. They prefer to have noodles or rice. So we actually give Japanese people a specific menu. So understanding cultural differences is as important as understanding the language differences.
It can sometimes actually keep you out of danger. I remember once being in a crowd in Moscow just after the collapse of the Soviet Union, and the crowd was just becoming a little bit hostile to foreigners. It was that time when the mood in Russia was shifting away from being open to the West to being a bit sceptical about whether the West was there to help them or not. And they began mushering and saying, who are these foreigners and what do they want? And we're not sure that we like them. I could, of course, understand. We'd been talking in English among ourselves, but I switched over to Russian and said to them, look, we're just here to hear your point of view. We want to know what you think. And because I was speaking to them directly and because I was speaking in Russian, the mood changed and they immediately became very friendly and wanted to give us interviews and were very hospitable towards us.
Just a small example was when I used to work on check-in, and we used to have a lot of Japanese people that used to fly through Birmingham. And when they walked up to the check-in desk, they always used to bow a little bit. And although it feels quite odd to bow at somebody, we used to make sure that we would bow back.
Okay then, what could I do next with languages? Any tips?
I want to be an architect when I'm older. But I might have to travel to different countries to design houses in different countries. They want to understand what I'm saying and how I can help them design houses. So if I'm speaking in their language, it'll make them feel more confident about who's doing their job for them.
I didn't decide I wanted to do medicine until I started my A-levels when I was about 16. So just to be aware that you never know what's going to happen, you never know what kind of field you're going to go into, and no matter what you do, you're going to need languages. Now with job situations becoming more competitive, employers are really looking for the best CVs, and if you've got a language to offer, they're probably going to choose you over someone who doesn't have any language at all, but they'll definitely look upon it favourably.
I would say don't just think about it, actually do it. So many students have come back to me with regrets and said, I'm so sad, you know, I didn't choose Spanish, I really regret it now. And very often students do come back later on in life to pay for languages, language lessons, you know. And my advice to you is, you know, you can get it for free now at school, so do it. And definitely it will make you stand out from other competitors.
Looking to do child psychology, and since French is spoken in a lot of countries, I could just go around helping children, go around to lots of schools, nurseries.
I'm thinking of journalism, so then I won't have to stay in one country.
Well, I know where I'm headed. Off to see where I can learn Japanese, which reminds me.
Palo, ahora me entro!
No, no. No, I don't want to order breakfast.
Si quisimas! Hey! Hey! Godzilla!
Ah. I know this one. Hang on. Gojira.
Buenos días, las chicas bonitas.
Hola.
Excusez-moi.
Pour boisson?
Je voudrais de l'eau minérale, s'il vous plaît.
Merci.
Une grande bouteille de vin, s'il vous plaît. Le service terrible.
Oui.
Mein Name ist Sam. Wenn Sie werden die Flüge meiner Hilfen brauchen, dann frage die Zoc mit der Nacht mehr.
Yeah.